I've heard that you have been all very sick. I think I got sick because of that myself. Now I hope you are all better. Still there are sick people? How many?
About 70.
Seven?
70.
70 are sick in bed. Where are they? Now, there's something I must tell you that the other day these girls were making me wear ornaments and I felt very funny smell from them. So I think that you people do not wash your hands properly. After going to the toilet, I told you to use water all the time. It's very important. But you people stick still to the Western style, that's very dirty, I tell you. It's a very dirty style of living. It is not to use the water. It's very unhygienic also. That's why you find in the West most of the people are sick. Not here, you have seen yesterday how the boys were dancing. So quick and fast. So that's one thing one has to remember, is to wash your hands after coming out of the toilet, before food. Yesterday I smelt their hands and I was amazed, smelling awfully bad. So that's not an Indian custom or anything, but it's a hygienic system. So I hope you have got lotus. Have you got lotus there? You had it. But still you keep to that dirty thing with which you have got AIDS, you got all your problems because of that dirty habits. So please try to understand. Now in England or anywhere I've seen you use spoons, forks and other things, you see. Don't use directly your hands. When you don't use your hands directly, it's all right. But also I think it's a dirty habit in any case. But if you're using forks or spoons or something, it's at least you're not touching your food with that dirty hands. Only that time I realized that these people have again taken to the bad habits. This paper business is the dirtiest. People, you are so much used to that smell that you do not feel it. But I have seen it even when we have receptions and things, I am sitting there meeting people, or even if I am shaking hands with them, I feel terrible. The smell is too much in the hands. The sensitivity is lost. You cannot feel the smell. Can you smell your hands now? Let's see. You feel that? It's no need to put any saints or anything, but with the soap nicely. Here in India we use our clay, because clay in India is very good, you can use the clay. Just use the clay nicely and clean your hand. It's very important. And that's why I've seen that in the West everybody is sick all the time. There's something wrong, something. We never find them healthy. I think this is one of the reasons. Something is always wrong with them. Indians were there, they all had the same food as you ate. Nothing happened to them. And we had made special arrangement for water also. But this is something you're very negligent about. You have to be very careful. I don't know how you manage. We can't live without it. Even if supposing we go to some place and there's nothing available, just we have to use the paper sometimes. Even in England, sometimes in... We come back home immediately and have a bath. So personal cleanliness is very important anywhere. Here you cannot blame anything to anything, because I've seen people who ate the same food, live there, they are quite healthy and hearty. Nothing has gone wrong with them. And we don't also eat too much of raw food. That's also another thing good. Is that there's no question of thing falling into it. Moreover, even if somebody told me that the utensils were washed in the lake, doesn't matter, but the food was cooked. You see, once you put it on the fire, it all cleanses out. It cannot give you this sickness. Then secondly, I've seen you're very negligent about also covering up yourself. You must take a shawl all the time. Even if you feel a little warm, doesn't matter. But you can take it out. But keep it handy all the time. That's also you get sick, because there's dust everywhere. And if you have a shawl around, at least you are protected. So you should always wear those bandis we have given you. That has come free with the cloth, with the dresses that you have bought. And the ladies must keep their shawls with them. We have to respect our body, because these bodies are not ordinary bodies, they are temples of God. Thirdly, I have been requesting you to put some oil in your heads at least once a week. But now the fashion is not to put any oil. So you don't want to put any oil on your heads. At least once a week you must put some oil in your head. That will keep your head cool. And also before taking bath, use some oil for rubbing on your hands or on your body. We always do that. You people don't have any oil with you? Do you have any oil? Sure? Then please rub it on your body before taking your baths. You must rub oil on your body nicely before taking your baths. Also, I have seen people in the West don't do it. Just never use oil. Before taking bath, at least for 15 minutes, rub oil on your bodies. Now, very simple things, but you just don't do it. I just don't know. It's a few things if you look after, I think you'll be all right. And if you are sitting outside, cover your heads. It has been rather cold this time. Winter has been little cooler than before. Reason is it has rained a lot. But I mean, compared to your country, it's not cold. But negligence can cause it. So please keep yourself covered. And then have your baths. If you take bath with cold water, you can never catch cold because the temperature is the same. For a while you will feel it's cold water, but it's very good. Those people who take bath with cold water, did you get hot water to have baths? Where? You had hot water. That's very wrong. That's the reason. That explains. If you have to take bath with hot water, then you must get into your bed. If you have to take it in the open, sure shot you'll get temperature. Absolutely sure shot. This is a very simple thing, which I don't know how you don't know. You should never take your bath in the open with the hot water. That's sure shot. I mean, anybody who wants to, you see, in the school, supposing some boy doesn't want to go. So what he does, he keeps the window open and takes his bath with hot water. Finished. He gets the temperature immediately next day. So in Brahmapuri, if they have given you hot water, you should not have taken bath. That was wrong. Even if you had got, I mean, River Ganges, I don't know if you have, how many have been to River Ganges? You have been. Now the water is freezing cold, I tell you. It's absolutely freezing cold. When you put your foot, you'll just push it back. It's so cold. But people get into it slowly, slowly, they just move, slip into it. And when you come out, your cheeks are red like apples. It's so very cold, isn't it? But nothing happens. Nobody catches cold or anything. So in the running water is the cleanest, and where you could get into cold water. Otherwise, even if you have to take a hot water bath, take it in the night or maybe at the time when you can go off into your bed. In England also people take their baths in the night mostly and get into bed. Supposing you take hot bath in England and go out, immediately you'll get cancer of the lungs. Hot and cold is a very important thing one has to know. Like also you can see on the hands, you feel hot and cold. So now supposing you have taken the coffee. After that, you cannot take anything cold. It's a simple thing, one should understand. First, you can take anything cold. Like I have seen people take coffee and then ice cream. I'm sure you get troubles. Absolutely sure. But if you are taking ice cream, first take ice cream. Then take a biscuit, and then take some water, then take some biscuit, and then you can take something hot. Now supposing you have taken something hot and you have to take water also. Then take 3 biscuits. Another very great precaution you have to take, which I have seen nobody takes. Now it's sometimes become very hot outside. You are sitting down into programs or something, becomes very hot, you are sitting in the sun sometimes and your head gets very heated up. Immediately you go and get cold water. Definitely you'll get sick. No doubt about it. That's the best way to get sick. So if you are sitting in the sun, immediately you should never take any water till you have eaten something sweet. Take some sugar or take some jaggery or some biscuit or something. Even if you are very thirsty, you should not do it. Little precautions have been taken. Nothing should happen to Sahaja Yogis, because if you get sick, I get sick. That's the problem is. And that's why I was so sick yesterday. I knew that you must be already sick, that's why it has happened to me. I mean, I work much harder than you people do. Unending meetings are there, I have to meet other people apart from you, give me realizations to them, discuss all other organizational problems, this, that, nothing happens to me. But these precautions must be taken. How to be sangat ka nahi alokana? Look at these Indians. They are traveling with you, they are all right. Nobody is sick. Why? None of them are sick. You see, from our childhood it is taught to us, we must wash our hands at least 10 times a day. And then too much tea. You people take too much tea. It's very injurious for the intestines. Very injurious. It has tannin, you know that. So much tea you people take is very wrong. Plus milk with it. Milk gives you diarrhea. Limit your tea taking. Or even if you have to take many cups of tea, then see that it's a very light tea, extremely light, very light tea. But this Marathi tea, only 1 cup in the morning is sufficient. Too much tea is very dangerous. I mean, it's easily available here. They don't mind even if you have a full drum of a tea, each person. But it's not good for you. Too much tea is not good at all. So limit your tea taking. Also, all the time to take tea is not a very good idea. It's some sort of a thing that has happened, I think, is the attention part. Attention. Now ask Indians how many times they take tea. Though we grow so much tea here. Kitna cha pita? Donda. At the most 2 times. If they have taken early in the morning tea, they will not have any tea for breakfast. And once in the evening, finished. If there is a music program in the night, they might take 1 cup. Because they know, because of this tea, your stomach goes out of order, you cannot sleep. It's a very wrong thing. But I have seen when I was building my house, or I should say when I was doing renovation of my house, that at the slightest pretext they used to enter into the kitchen, make tea, drink it. 15 cups, 20 cups, still wonder, what's the matter with these people? Of course, cheap to give tea is all right. Doesn't cost much money, but it's very dangerous. So reduce your intake of tea, and water should be increased. More water, less of tea. Tea itself is not a very good thing. If you see how much your mother takes tea, you see, I may take even 10 cups of tea, but so much of tea will be there for 10 cups. Just the water, you see, just to please people, I'm taking tea. And no sugar, no milk. That you know very well. Everybody knows. No sugar, no milk, finished. Milk itself gives diarrhea. Just like that, I don't mind sugar otherwise for liver patients, but not too much of it also. Those who are liver patients can take sugar. Otherwise, normally we should not take too much sugar also. All these little things, if you look after, it will be all right. Tonight I have arranged for them. Arlaka, ova arla? Ova arlaka? I hope so. They are arranging some ajwain duni. All should have it. It's a very good thing. ajwain. Also those who are having diarrhea can have it, it's all right. Just clears you out completely. And diarrhea should not make you weak. I mean, I normally, in a 1 month's time, I have at least 20 days diarrhea. Really. The reason is I take everybody's problems upon myself and it goes out as diarrhea. But it doesn't make me weak. So just the attention is diarrhea. Diarrhea is important sometimes to cleanse you out, it's important. To me, it's a relief. If it is 35 motions or 40 motions, then it's all right. But 3-4 motions is very good sometimes. Also, Indian food is a heavy food. It's not so light as we have English food or Western food. It's very light, easy to digest. Indian food is not. So that's why I ask you to dance, to have some exercises so you can digest it. While we are all having sedentary habits mostly, we are sitting down doing nothing. See, Indians are working, we are not working at all. So we should do little walking or some exercises. It's a heavy food, no doubt. But you cannot make it very light. Though I tell them, make it very light, no chilies, nothing. They are trying. For example, today's lunch was really too much for me. It's all right, once in a while you eat it. And evening time I told them to give you a very simple food. So that's how it can be compensated. That evening time simple food, daytime heavy, or the evening time it is heavy, then daytime simple food. But Indians are like that, they want, they're fond of, you see, they have this fondness to feed you, very anxious to feed you. But don't fall a trap to that. You should just say no, no, no. They'll go on saying, please have, they feel very happy. They themselves, if you see, they don't eat so much. They're very clever. You see them how much they eat. They'll get up at 5 o'clock, have their bath, they're ready for everything. In the whole day, if you see, they eat very little themselves. And you know how much I eat myself. But if it comes to telling people to eat, I'll say, please have more, please have more. But you should not listen there. As much as you can tolerate, take it. Because you may not be able to digest. I will say it because I don't want you to feel embarrassed how to take more, so I'll say, go on, eat more. But you should not listen. I think most of our problems are solved now, as far as marriages are concerned. And perhaps maybe one marriage we have to neutralize a little bit. And there's somebody coming also from Simla. I think according to the Western standard, he's a handsome man. You can use him for a model, according to the Western style. But according to Indian style, he's not. He's quite a person who looks like all the models I see in Harrods. It's very surprising. And according to yogi thought, he may not be appreciated because of his looks. I said, what? See, they all have like this only faces. I saw them in Harrods, so many of them put out as models. So there's somebody coming down and yogi is bringing him tomorrow. So there's one more person is coming. And I hope not last minute people don't stand up just to say that I want to get married. Achha, apna te gele ka pude? Khan sahib agare? Where is Mr. Khan? Nahi aati the? Is he not here? Khan sahib raha le the? Nahi, Kolkata che. Aale? Oh, I see. He must have gone somewhere. All right. त्यांना ती पिंपळी मागून आलेली पिंपळी आणि ज्यांना ज्यांना खोकरा आहे त्यांना दिलं आणि आज ओव्याची धुनी त्या सगळ्यांना होतील ठीक होती पाणी केलं आहे बडी बडीशेप आणि पुदिन्याचं हो आणलंय आणा वाटत करून आणा आय मेड सम मेडिसिन फॉर यू फॉर दिस डायरिया बिझनेस बट आय थिंक वन शूड नॉट पे सो मच अटेन्शन टू डायरिया इट्स बेटर क्लेन्स इट आउट इट्स क्लेन्सिंग But do you feel very weak with diarrhea? Do you? High fever, now it's all right. Temperature has come down. Then put them right to the left. If it is high temperature, put them right to the left. If it is diarrhea, then no problems. But diarrhea is all right because it's parasympathetic activity. It's cleansing, you see. I always have diarrhea. I'm telling you, out of 30 days, at least 20 days minimum, I have diarrhea. But I'm quite all right because it's just cleansing out. But if you go on thinking, I have diarrhea, I've got headache, I have this, then even if you are not sick, you'll feel more sick. One should not pay so much attention. What was the temperature? How much? No, you tell me in this thing, I don't understand. 100 and how much? Hundred. Hundred is no temperature. It's nothing. Was that 104? Oh, then it's no temperature. It's all right. High fever means 104. Yes, it is. But they must have taken. If you take bath with hot water, you can try. In the open, immediately you'll get 100 temperature. Immediately. Is absolutely inevitable. I don't know how you don't know these things. You don't know, doctor? With the yogurt, what happened? But diarrhea is not to be feared so much, doctor. And you see, 100 temperature is no temperature at all. It's all right once in a while. So many times, if I feel my temperature, I'll go mad. Right? It's nothing, you see, temperature is there because of the heat, something. 102 is nothing. It's like this, not something to be reported. I personally think that way. See, आपल्याकडे कुणाल ताप आला तर सांगत बसतो का आपण? Indians for us 102 is no temperature. You people are very delicate. I must say, very delicate health you have. You saw the boys how they were there dancing. You saw the way they were doing things. You see, it's life is so active. The body's the lethargic nature. See, makes you so delicate. You saw yesterday how they were doing all this. That's very common. I also used to learn all that. We all have to learn. So you keep your body moving and this thing. You'd go to a college even if you have 102 temperature. Okay? It's not much. But you are very delicate and bearing power is less. I think so. 104, of course, we start worrying, but 102 is not much. I thought you are so sick that it's 106. Really, I got worried. But for that, you just move left to the right, you'll be all right. This is because of not using proper precautions. Now, don't take hot bath in the open. Just this much you try. There's no harm in getting into cold water. Cold is always good. Always get into cold water. Take your bath in the cold water. You'll never catch cold. See, when I was in India, I always used absolutely cold water. But when I went to England, everybody told me you can't do that. Just forced me to take hot water and I started getting cold. Otherwise, I never get cold. So hot water should be used. All right, use the hot water, then get into your beds. That's the best way to get into temperature, I tell you. Just avoid hot water bath. But if you take a hot water bath, see to it that you take the hot water bath and after that you get into your beds. No exposure. All right? So some vibrations that it have. We made a medicine which doesn't look very interesting, but it won't taste bad. Sakhar gaate ka? Sakhar gaate. For diarrhea only. Not for everyone, only those who have diarrhea. Also, if you can remember one thing more, is to when you come out of these processions, you just gargle with little warm water or even ordinary water, you gargle out. So the dust will come. There may be a dust, you are not used to the dust. That's also another reason you get this coughing. Are they here, those who have temperature? Huh? Not here. Can you see if they have temperature now? I was worried the way it was told to me. I thought some sort of an epidemic has come or what? Really? Like plague, you know? The description was so horrible. Some of you have had some gurus, you see, and that's why also the void acts very fast. They must be the first time they must be visiting, most of them. They must have this guru trouble and the void must be showing off. What has happened to Patrice from Shuri camp? Where is he? What's gone wrong with you, Patrice? Huh? What's he saying? This is a vibrate conductor. Yes, sir. Salamare. Sakha jatta na kumare. Yes,
sir. Yes? Yesterday I couldn't move.
You couldn't what?
I couldn't
move.
Move? Yes, I have pain in my bones and I have fever and diarrhea. I tried to stay during the whole puja and at the end I almost collapsed. My chakras were blocked from the gunadhara to the Kalisha.
What happened?
I don't know. I swallowed some water.
Huh? Solid what?
Swallowed some water from the Krishna River.
Drank some water?
Well, I didn't mean to drink it. I just had a stick and drank. So I don't know if that's the reason for it.
No, the Krishna is flowing. There's no problem.
Yeah.
They were saying that you were talking something or something. You were saying things. Funny things you were saying.
Anything?
Ah. Do you remember that? Did you say that? Somebody told me that way. Was he like that? Anyone saw him? Dr. Spira? Huh?
I didn't hear him being delirious when
he was. They said he was delirious. I thought must be his temperature must be very high. I don't know what happened. Did anyone see him talking too much or something?
Not really.
Huh?
He looks quite bad.
No, but what was the thing? What did he do? Not hilarious. Oh, what was it?
He was looking at a bad color. A bad color, he was having a lot of diarrhea, and now he's better.
Let me see your temperature. Come on. I would like to see. He was not that bad. He didn't have any high temperature, did he? But did you find him hilarious or something? What's he saying? Getting vibrations? Alright. You're alright. Not much temperature, okay. It doesn't have much temperature as such to get hilarious. So the speak temperature cannot be so much then. It's not so much. Might be 99 or might be so, at the most.
I think fever was such a problem too much.
What was the problem with the idea?
Just the diarrhea and some vomiting and frustration.
How many times they for diarrhea? How much on the average?
I don't know what average is. Some people had it 4 or 5 times, some had it 20 times.
That's sick. That being sick, 20 times. And they had also vomiting?
Yes. Patrice was one of these. Patrice was one of it quite a lot during the night and so on. But he's improving now, Mother. He's on the improving.
But Patrice needed to be cleared out. Patrice, you have done some other practices, isn't it, in your seeking? Patrice, you've done something like that before. Yeah, and I think drugs. That's clearing out. It's good for you. Get it clear out. Drugs.
Anyone with a fever, we just suggested they sleep on the ground in the shade and let the fever be sucked out by the earth.
Mm.
And it seems to work.
Yeah. We also put the clay on the stomach to take out the temperature. It's a natural way. But I think it's drugs and bad gurus and things spoils your void. And then when you come to Sahaja Yoga, it just comes out in this way. So let it be cleared out. I think Petrus had problem with his void. I knew this long time back.
Well, it stirred up after your puja, That's when a lot of them actually started after your puja. So we naturally assume that it's a clearing out and we're not trying to stop it. So.
No, let it be. It's better. Must be. After puja, if it has happened, it's very good. I think it should happen after puja.
We're just replacing now
But dahi in the night won't be good.
This
will give morning is alright. Morning buttermilk is much better than dahi also, buttermilk. That's much more soothing. So if you can make buttermilk, nothing like it. Take more buttermilk. But coffee and buttermilk, I don't know.
Can they have coffee as a cure for the diarrhea or not?
I don't know. This just stops it, that's all. Take buttermilk. Jana ki nahi? Isav gol barobar dya. With isav gol. Take buttermilk. Buttermilk is much better. Soothes you down. Slowly, slowly it will improve. But this coffee, just to see, it sort of stops it and augments the whole thing. That's not very sensible, is it, to give a shock to your system. Coffee is just not a curative. It just stops the idea. I don't know why we should stop it. Let it be cleansed out unless and until you are absolutely very weak. But this is something called electrol here, you get it.
Yeah, we're using that.
That's good.
And we're also using rice water, pears, when we can get it. Again, Mr. Pata, we find enough to give us the seed also.
Yes, you could have a lot of water things. I think it's necessary sometimes to cleanse out. Also drugs. They should get out of your system. Very important. Very important. If it is there, it should get out. If it is happening after my puja, I think it's stirring up inside. But you just look after that day, don't get too much of diarrhea. And too much of temperature. But temperature should, if it's 102, I don't think it's much. But if it is more than that, then you have to be careful. I was rather concerned, you know, I came to know about your sickness. And don't think too much about sickness also. Now, I have to talk, please be seated, to a little bit to the Australians. And because for me, Australians, English, French, all of you are my children. And we all should know everything about everything. So there should be no exclusion of Australians or anybody. This can happen to anyone. And Australia being such a powerful Sahaja Yogi country, that it has happened there, a very sad thing. We have had three shocks, one after another in Australia. I think there are two types of people in Australia. One type who are all the time very dominating type and try to take over. And there's another type which is extremely obedient and subservient. They haven't kept their heads open. We are all Sahaja Yogis. And nobody has business to dominate you or to take advantage of you or to organize you in that way. Any leader who does that has to pay for it very heavily. And also the part that the wife has to play as the leader's wife, she has to understand that she's just a mother and she has no authority as a leader's wife. In case of Australia, we have had lots of problems because Australians have a special feeling for their wives. I don't know why, in Sahaja Yoga, otherwise not. I think the greatest temptation they have is to have a family. Australians have this greatest temptation that we must have a family, we must look after our family, this, that. And this might have come because people have seen broken families, they have seen the problems of broken families, and there have been so much writings about it that we should not neglect our family, we should look after our children, look after our wives and this and that. Of course, in Sahaja Yoga, we respect family very much, but not beyond the bigger family. About James, I have to tell you one thing, that he gave me the greatest shock. The first shock came from his cousin, whom you know, Terence, whose wife was Indian, but she also in his ego became like a small Mataji. She used to order about, I will have this, I will not, they would occupy my room and enjoy that. Then came Mr. Warren, he was another horrid fellow. You see, such leaders are coming out of that place, I'm surprised. Then he came here, he never told me that he was paid money or he collected money, nothing of the kind. I never knew anything. Only once in that delay, somebody remarked that he has been collecting money, so I asked him, what money are you collecting? Without my knowledge, he did so many things, and I've never known such people before. Though I was telling him, your navi is catching, muladhara catching, this, that, but I never knew that there could be people of that level. So we had, in the same relationship, James there. James was a very simple man, no doubt. When he first came to see me, he was very upset. I said, James, why are you upset? He said, Mother, I have an air hostess. I'm telling you all these things because I have to talk to you about it. An air hostess who is my wife, but she doesn't stay with me. She has to stay in Sydney. I'm working here. And I don't know why she doesn't write to me much. I go send her presents. I see her very often, all that. I told her, James, if you don't mind, I'll tell you the truth. He said, no, no, Mother, please tell me the truth. I said, already she's carrying on with another man. She has nothing to do with you. And he was shocked. Then I soothed him. I said, you better call her. So he went to Sydney and called her, and she got herself very nicely dressed. She came for the dinner. And there she openly told him that she's already living with another man. That's how he came to Sahaja Yoga. So his first marriage was broken. After coming to Sahaja Yoga, he wanted to have another marriage. That was all right. Then this girl died. She wanted to marry. Now, I have no idea about this homosexuality. To be very frank, till today I don't understand what is this nonsense. And that the women are homosexual, I have never heard of this before, we have never known. I didn't know that she was that kind of a person. But of course she was not so normal, not so this thing, but she was after me, she wanted to marry Terence and then to James. I told her, Terence is no good for you, but James you can marry. She was after me that she wanted to get married. All right, I said, you can marry James. There were not many girls in those days, but James wanted to have a wife somehow. So he married this girl. Now I have got letters which Matthias has given me, written from his wife who went down. I agree that his wife carried lots of boots with him, but the fraternity worked and she and other 8 girls just jumped on her. And they formed a formidable group there, which I have got now, complete record and complete report about them, how they were dominating. They were very hard women, dominating all the rest of them there. And such regulations and rules she started. It happened in the beginning when I asked her to get out and go to Ruth, because the ladies came and told me. She went to Ruth, there she knew that she would lose everything, she behaved herself nicely, everything. I said, all right, you go back. So it was not a possession, but a kind of that homosexual aggressiveness in her. Then Matthias has given me her letters when she went, his wife went there. And it's absurd letters. She used to sleep with her, and she used to hug her, she used to kiss her, and do all kinds of things with a lady who has gone there to get cured. And they were very important people. She was a very important person. Another person I know is Patrick's wife. She went down there, and she didn't get better. On the contrary, she became worse. And I told Patrick. And Patrick has been there. He was so much influenced by these 2 persons because they tried to show that all the rest of the world is very bad, they are very unkind, we are very loving people, we are very nice, this, that, and Patrick is something great. You see, just pampered his ego perhaps. Poor baby. Patrick is such a simple-hearted fellow. He came to France and I was to speak. I have to speak that time. I said, Patrick, why don't you translate me? He just couldn't utter a word. He was tongue-tied. He said, Mother, what has happened to me? He said, some honeybees or something has caught him. I said, no honeybees, this is some Australian honeybees. So one must understand that though the quantity of Australians has increased, quality has to go up. More of group farming is a very common thing in Australia, which is very wrong. When you are increasing this way, you must know that we must also increase this way. And all this happened last year when the Indians also reported to me that Australians are all possessed. I said, really? Yes. They are always saying, Australia is great, Australia is great. And they are saying all these things. And they said they were taking their own decision. There was one Mr. Charles was off his head. He was like a Hitler. That's what the Indians told me. I was quite shocked. Then they lost the sari, they found the sari, and I could see now there's something going on. My attention was not there. But on my birthday, I telephoned to James because not a single flower came from Australia on my birthday. As it is, I've noticed one thing with this lady, his wife. She has been extremely miserly as far as giving presents to me. I mean, so miserly. It's so stupid the way she gave me a little brooch like this once when I came for Australian tour. She need not have given. And she went to me and she sent me this, and even after all this, she sent me a nylon, what you call that, is a, for keeping handkerchiefs, a little. So stupid she is, she has no sense of any kind. And she was getting from bad to worse. And on this side, you see, when I telephoned from my house, they said James has gone, nobody wished me anything on the phone, nothing. James has gone to New Zealand. I said, all right, I telephoned to New Zealand. What I find, he didn't wish me. I said, James, do you know today's my birthday? Oh, yes, yes, yesterday we celebrated in Australia. What? You can't even say, Mother, happy returns or something. Not a single flower to me. As if my photograph has become the reality and I have become unreal.